Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we will be studying chapter Plant Water Relation and Mineral Nutrition. In that, we are studying topic elements which are required for plant growth. Soil consists of various elements, or you can say nutrients. For example, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur, and so on, which are required for plant growth. We'll be studying today that. Elements are very essential for plant growth. If soil was not rich in elements, or you can say nutritional content, no plant on earth would be able to grow prosperously. Every cellular activity which takes place inside cell requires certain elements. In nature or in soil, there are two forms of elements that are available. One are macro elements and another are micro elements. When I say macro elements, these elements are required in larger quantity by the plants for their growth and cellular activities. An example of this is carbon, oxygen, nitrogen, which are required for major cellular activities. Whereas certain elements like the micro elements are required in smaller quantities, but they are vital and essential for a plant growth and development. Micro elements can also be called as non-essential elements. Example, aluminium. An example of micro elements can be potassium, calcium, magnesium, and copper. Those are required in little or trace amounts in plants. But if copper is not present inside a plant, then ETC cycle or ETS cycle, that is electron transport chain, would not take place, since cytochrome oxidase will not be formed inside a plant cell. That is the importance of copper. Magnesium or Mg+ is an important component inside the chlorophyll of a leaf. And we all know, if there is no chlorophyll or chloroplast present inside leaf, then the process of photosynthesis will come to a standstill, or the process of photosynthesis will not take place. Potassium. When I say potassium or K+ ions are basically important for maintaining the ionic balance inside a cell. Similar to humans, plants need to maintain their ionic balance or ionic equilibrium, and sodium and potassium, Na+ and K+, play a vital role in that. Nitrogen. Nitrogen is present in greater amounts in soil, and the importance of nitrogen is in formation of nucleic acid, that is the DNA of a plant. Apart from that, all the plant hormones, that is auxins, cytokinins, gibberellins, require nitrogen in their formation and development. Even leguminous plants, for that matter, require 90% nitrogen for their growth. Carbon, hydrogen, all these elements form the network, or you can say the framework, of the cell wall. Elements like aluminium help in certain processes of glycolysis, or you can say the protein metabolism. The two most types of elements which are required for plant growth are the macro elements and the micro elements. When I say macro, it means the elements which are required in greater quantity. Example is carbon, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur. Whereas micro elements are essential for metabolic activities of plant, but they are required in trace amounts or in little amounts. Example of micro elements could be magnesium, copper, calcium. The various elements that help in the growth of plants are carbon, nitrogen, potassium, calcium, magnesium, and copper. Among this, carbon is a macro element which is required in larger quantities for a plant growth. Carbon basically forms the framework element, or you can say the stable bodies, that is the cell wall formation, is majorly dependent on carbon. Apart from that, this cell wall provides the rigidity to a plant cell, and this is taken care by the production of carbon in a plant cell. Nitrogen. All leguminous plants require nitrogen for their growth. Apart from that, nitrogen is used to make DNA or nucleic acid inside plant cell. Plant hormones also are dependent at nitrogen synthesis or nitrogen production. Potassium, or you can say K+, helps to maintain ionic balance inside a plant cell. Calcium is important component of chlorophyll, which is used for the process of photosynthesis. Magnesium and calcium together help in membrane permeability sometimes. Copper, an important product of ETS, or electron transport system, which helps to form the enzyme cytochrome oxidase, an important electron carrier in ETS, or electron transport system, which takes place during the process of glycolysis, or one of the parts of glycolysis after pyruvate is formed in the process of glycolysis. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about various micronutrients as well as macronutrients that are found inside the plant cell. I hope you all are clear with this concept of elements which are required in plant cell growth. Thank you.